Welcome back, Kilted Piper again. I want to go into doing some videos on some other aspects of the kilt. This one, I'm going to go into some maintenance aspects of the kilt. Specifically, cleaning your kilt. Worst thing you could do to a kilt is send it to the dry cleaners. Never, ever, ever send your kilt to a dry cleaners. That is a quick way to ruin your kilt. Dry cleaning does not mean it's dry. It is put into a tub with caustic chemicals that are used to clean the fabric, break down sediments, things that are on the fabric. Those caustic chemicals also will break down the fabric itself. They will destroy a kilt. A kilt is not made, it's not designed to be dry cleaned like that. Also, the leather straps on your kilt. Kilt has three leather straps for a traditional kilt. Three leather, short leather straps with a buckle. You have, I'll go ahead and take this belt off real quick, just so you can see the kilt a little better. Over on the left side here, we have short leather strap and buckle. Over here on the right side, we have two leather straps and buckles. These leather straps here are what holds the kilt on. This is purely for looks. You do not wear a belt to hold your kilt on. The kilt is held up by itself. It's the only reason I wear a belt over the top of my kilt, is for the aesthetics of it and a place for my lighter, keys, and a change bag to hold on to. Those leather straps on the kilt are not designed to be dry cleaned. Leather does not like dry cleaning. That dry cleaning will deteriorate those leather straps. Also, the pleats on the back of the kilt. Those pleats should be a nice razor or knife edge. They are folded very crisply, pressed very crisply along the edge. Again, each edge of this pleat should have a nice crisp edge to it. Dry cleaners, especially here in the United States, do not know how to pleat a kilt and press a kilt. Most of them have never touched a kilt before. So when they press the kilt, they press it the way they normally would any other clothing that comes through, and your pleats are ruined on the back of the kilt. It ends up coming back to you looking like a shower curtain. Rolled pleats on the back instead of nice, crisp, straight line edges. It is a very time-consuming process to press a kilt. You have to make sure that each and every pleat across the back of the kilt are all lined up perfectly before it's pressed. That way it comes out the same way the kilt was designed. All those stripes are perfectly straight. You don't have anything, any waves in those stripes. What I recommend is never, ever send your kilt to a dry cleaner's. There is no need for it. When I first started wearing a kilt, I sent one to a dry cleaner before I knew better. That kilt was ruined. It came back looking like a shower curtain. I had to learn how to repleat the kilt myself. Luckily, I only sent it to the dry cleaners one time, so it didn't break down the leather material, the straps, and the chemicals didn't break down the wool of the kilt. There isn't a need to send your kilts off and have them cleaned. You can clean it yourself a lot better than they can. A lot cheaper than they can. You come out with a lot better results. Had a friend the other day ask me why I like the umpal-shaped pipes, or the full bent pipes. This is one of the reasons. I can keep my pipe in my shirt pocket ready to go. It's already had its char light. It's not going anywhere. The tobacco's not falling out. I take the stem, go right back around over the top. It sits right side up in my shirt pocket while I'm going about my day. When I get ready to smoke a pipe, I can go ahead and pull it out, line it back up, and go ahead and light her on up. A second. Fan's blowing just a little bit too much today. And my Savinelli 614 acrylic. Smoking some Dunhill early morning pipe today. On the kilts, to clean it yourself, all you need is a bathtub, Johnson's Baby Shampoo, don't use Woolite, Johnson's Baby Shampoo, and a drying rack. That's all you need to properly clean your kilt. Now what you want to do is put your bathtub about that deep with water. warm water, not hot, just warm water, with a little Johnson's baby shampoo. You want a very mild shampoo. We don't want to cause any damage to the wool. Now, baby shampoo is made for hair. Wool is hair. This is the hair of the sheep. It's all wool is. Treat it as you would your own hair. Or a baby's hair. We want to be gentle when we're cleaning it. So, little Johnson's baby shampoo in the water. Take the kilt, lay it in the bathtub. Lay it in the bathtub, let it soak. And go ahead and push it down into the water so the whole material is thoroughly soaked in the wash solution. Let it soak for a while. I let mine soak for a couple hours. You don't want the water to be hot. We don't want any shrinkage happening in the fibers. We want them to stay relaxed. Do not ever twist, wring, or wad up the kilt material. That will ruin the material. You're going to break down the fibers. Leave it alone. Let it soak in the water. While it's soaking, you can take and kind of knead on the kilt in the water, kind of swishing it around a little bit. But leave the kilt laying flat in the tub. After a while, I'll go ahead and pick it up, turn it over, lay it flat on the other side in the tub. Just let it soak like that for a couple hours. We don't want to be in a hurry when we're cleaning our kilts. Let that cleaning solution, the warm water and the Johnson's baby shampoo, slowly work its way into the fibers and lift out the oils from your skin, pollutants from the air, things like that that have gotten onto the kilt material. Once that has soaked for a while, go ahead and drain the wash solution out of the tub. Fill it back with rinse water. Same thing, leaving it flat in the water. Kind of knead down on it a little bit, swishing it around in the water. Rinse the shampoo out of the kilt material. May have to do that a couple times. Start getting the waters discolored. It bubbles from your soap. You shouldn't be putting, if you have bubbles in your rinse water, you used way too much shampoo. It doesn't take much. I use a capful, actually about half a capful off the shampoo bottle. Mix it in with the water. You don't need a whole lot. Go ahead and drain that water out, fill it up again. You may have to do that two or three times until the water comes out clear. Once the water comes out clear, you're finished. Now comes the hard part. That kilt is going to be very heavy now. Those fibers have absorbed a lot of water. If you just hang that kilt up, you're going to break the hanger that you're trying to hang it on. You take a chance on damaging the kilt. So we don't want to do that until the kilt is dried. We need a drying rack. I'm going to go ahead and put a picture up on here of the drying rack that I use. If I've got this one off Amazon, I will double check, and I'll go ahead and put a link in the comments below, or the description below, where you can pick up this dry rack that I use on Amazon. Now with this rack, I will open it up so the rack is laying flat. I will then take the kilt, lay it out across that rack. Lay the kilt out across the top of this rack. Let it dry, laying flat. Once the kilt has dried, then you can hang the kilt up. At least wait until it's mostly dry. You want to get rid of that water weight from it before you hang this kilt up. If you hang the kilt up, the weight from the water is now pulling down on that fabric. You're going to distort the fabric. We don't want to do that. As you can see, this is a very simple process to cleaning your kilts. These kilts are made to last for years. I have a couple kilts that are close to 100 years old now. They are meant to last generations. Your kilts should be able to be handed down to your children, to your grandchildren. That material should last that long. Not like a pair of blue jeans that in a couple years you're going to throw them away, they're wore out. Kilts are not like that. Kilts are meant to last. So if we just use a few common sense techniques caring for the kilts, you have a piece of your history that you could share with future generations. We'll have more videos later on different topics of proper care for a kilt. If you have any other questions regarding kilts, pipes, Hawaii, whatever, send me an email. TheKiltedPiper@mail.com. And also go ahead and leave comments below on this video. Remember to hit that thumbs up if you liked the video, thumbs down if you didn't. Won't hurt my feelings either way. Subscribe if you haven't already. And share this video with somebody that you think would be interested in learning about how to care for a kilt. Until next time, aloha from Hawaii.